I said, Grandpa, what's this picture here? It's all in black and white. Dangerous bear, is that you there? He said, yeah, I was a little times were tough back in 45, that being Uncle Joe. You're trying to survive a pocket park in the Great Depression. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of gin trying to save each other, you should have seen it in the cover. This old kid was taken overseas in the middle of hell of 1943 in the winter time. You could almost see my breath. That was like a gunner, old Johnny McGee. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back right through the day he left. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, should have seen it in the cover. Pictures worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in the cover. This one is my favorite one. It's me and Grandma in the summer sun, all dressed up. The day we said our goodbyes. You can't feel it here, but it was hot that year. That rose was red and her eyes were blue. And just look at that smile. I was so proud. That's the story of my life. Right there in black and white. And if it looks like we were there to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, you should have seen it in the color. Pictures worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shapes of gray keep covered. You should have seen it in the color.
Checking it twice, gonna find out who's on your left.
Santa Claus is I thought of how the day had come The bells ring all over Christendom and roll along the unbroken song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. But in despair I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong, and watch the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then peal the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. For wrong shall fail and right prevail, with peace on earth, goodwill to men. For wrong shall fail and right prevail, with peace on earth and goodwill to men.
Oh, baby.
Paris license today. I would guess it would be a safe bet to say she's the youngest pilot here, I would say, right? Anybody want to challenge that? New pilot? Right, that's all we got. Let's go do some more Johnny Cash. How about one more Johnny Cash song? This is, I'll sing this this song in honor of my old friend Bob Odegaard, because he loved this song. Because Stang, you know, you all know Stang, the Mustang, was built on about 20 different Mustangs. And Johnny Cash wrote this song back in the early 70s, and when it came on the radio, a guy from Arkansas, I believe it was, owned a salvage yard and a rebuilding business, and he built a car exactly the way this song was. Well, one piece at a time. Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and moved to Newberg, working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on old Cadillac. Every day I'd watch those beauties go by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, because I always wanted to be one that was long black. So one day I devised myself a plan that should be the end of most any man. I sneak it out in a lunchbox in my hand. Getting caught, getting fired, but I figured have it all by the time we retired. I have me a car with at least $100,000. Well, I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll notice me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around inside, gonna drive everybody wild, because I'll have the only one there is around. So the very next day when I started here with my big lunchbox to help my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gears. Now I never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk. Then I got a transmission and all the chrome. The little things are getting my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shots, but the big stuff I snuck out my buddy's mobile home. Well, up to now, the plan went all right, so we tried to put it all together one night, and that's when we discovered that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53, and the engine turned out to be a 73, and when we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. But we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little help from an 8-applicant, we had that engine running just like a stone. Now the headlights, so that was another slap. We had two on the left and one on the right. When we pulled out the switch, all three of them came on. The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together and we got through. Well, that's when we noticed we only had one tail here. About that time, my wife came out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts, but she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So we took it uptown just to get the tag, and I headed her right on down Main Drive. I could hear people laughing for blocks around. Went up at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, they could type it up, it took the whole staff, and when they got done, the title weighed 65. I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll notice me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, gonna drive everybody wild, cause I have the only one there is around. But yeah, Red Rider, this is the Cottonmouth and the Psychobilly Cadillac, come on. This is the Cottonmouth and Negatory and the cost of this machine there, Red Rider. You might say it went down to the factory and picked it up. Keep it that way. Well, what model is it? Well, it's the Motorola 42. Well, it's 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59 automobiles. It's a 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70 automobiles. And I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll notice me when I come through your town. Thank you. Hey, thanks for having us today. Have a very good Christmas. We'll get back to the drawing here.